Heat pumps are said to have an efficiency of more than 100%. But doesn't that violate a couple of laws of thermodynamics? And is it really possible that the heat pump is producing more heat than the energy it consumes, or is that a lie? My name is Stefan, I'm a physics teacher, and I'm going to try to answer those questions. The short answers are no, the heat pump does not violate any of the laws of thermodynamics. It's actually using them. As for the second question, can a heat pump produce more heat than the energy that enters the pump? Well, there it gets a bit more complicated. Let me explain. So first, let's start by reviewing the laws of thermodynamics that are at play here. First, the first law of thermodynamics, of course. What does it say? The first law of thermodynamics says that no energy can be produced or destroyed. It can only be converted from one form to another or transferred from one object to another. That second part is what's important here, because we're not actually converting electric energy to drive the heat pump into heat, as does, for example, a baseball heater. Instead, as the name suggests, the heat pump pumps heat from outside of the building into the building, into the winter, when we want to heat the building up, and it pumps heat from inside the building to outside the building in the summer when we want to cool the building down. So the heat pump doesn't violate the first law of thermodynamics, it's actually using it as its working principle. What was the second law of thermodynamics again? In the most simple terms, the second law of thermodynamics says that heat by itself will always flow from hot to cold. So heat wants to flow from a hotter object to a colder object until both are in thermal equilibrium, meaning they have reached the same temperature. Heat engines take advantage of this by using some of that will of the heat to flow in that direction to get some mechanical work out of it. Now the heat pump kind of does the opposite. The heat by itself would flow from hot to cold. So in the winter, from your warmer building to the cold outside. That doesn't mean we cannot turn around that heat flow. It's only that this will not happen by itself. We will need to do something about it. In this case, you need to pump it from the cold side and make the outside that's already cold even colder and pump it inside the building. Think of it like water. It will always by itself fall down a waterfall. If you want to put the water back up, you will need to pump it, and to do so, you need some energy. Now, the good thing about that is that if the heat pump is well designed, the energy used to pump the heat from the outside to the inside is less than the actual energy of the heat that is being pumped. That is how heat pumps achieve an efficiency of more than 100%. How is efficiency calculated again? Well, it's the useful output of a machine over its input. So if we consider the heat delivered to the house or pumped out of the house as the useful output, and the input, the electrical energy needed to pump that amount of heat, then yes, good heat pumps can achieve 100% efficiency. Don't forget, the heat pump actually pumps the heat that it pumps to your house from the outside. So there is some free energy that we take from the environment by pumping it into the house. If you add the heat that the pump is taking from the environment for free to that input here, then of course you would go below 100%. Luckily, you don't have to pay for the heat that you pump from the outside in, and therefore what we really just care for is the amount of energy in that input that you have to pay for with your electricity bill. So in summary, no, the heat pump does not violate the rules of thermodynamics. It's actually using them to make your house warmer in the winter and make it colder in the summer. And if we only consider the energy that you have to pay for, in the case of an electric heat pump, the electricity, then yes, the heat pump achieves more than 100% efficiency. if you already have baseboard heaters in your house, replacing them with a heat pump is a very good idea energy-wise, as instead of converting one joule of electric energy into heat energy, the heat pump uses that one joule of electric energy to pump in 3, 4, 5 joules of heat into the house from the outside. The added benefit is also that a good heat pump can be reversed. So you can, in the summer, pump heat out of the house and use it as an air conditioner, something you cannot do with baseboard heat. If you're now interested in getting a heat pump, I suggest you watch the video where I explain to you what these different numbers on your heat pump quotes are meaning. Also, maybe if I put another video on a heat pump later on, it should be appearing here, so you can come back here and click on it and watch my other video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're not subscribed to my channel yet, the subscribe button.